Hey you guys, what's going on? It's your girl Dominique with Empathic Guidance. I'm back with another topic today. Basically, I'm letting other people choose the content of the videos thus far. It's been going pretty good, I guess. First, I would like to thank the new subscribers. And for anybody that's watching the channel that's not yet a subscriber, go ahead and hit that subscribe button for me. And also that notification bell so you can get future updates. Like and comment. And if you also have your own channel or any other small business, go ahead and leave a comment in the comment section because I definitely want to promote anybody that's willing to support me as well. So I'm gonna just get right into the topic. The topic of discussion is your significant other allowed to have friends of the opposite sex? Now, my immediate response when I posted it on Facebook was somebody commenting saying that your partner is allowed to do whatever the fuck they want. Excuse my French, but I just want to quote him and be, you know, say what he said verbatim. And so I know people know that's not politically correct to say that to allow your partner, but that was kind of how it was presented to me yesterday. So I kind of wanted to, like I said, put that out there verbatim. Surprisingly, with the comments that I did have, which was predominantly males commenting in response to that topic question, and they all pretty much agreed that their partner should be allowed to do whatever they want. And if you don't trust them to hang out with the opposite sex, then you're probably not meant to be with them, seeing as if you don't trust them. And I completely agree. And honestly, I can say about 2 years ago, I would have been one of those people that didn't want my partner to hang out with the opposite sex. That was a clashing topic in many of my relationships. And well, I only had 3 relationships, but pretty much that was a pattern that was in past relationships. And that was kind of like one of the downfalls to each of them. And, you know, when my friend kind of presented that topic, she immediately inserted her own opinion, which was actually that she doesn't want, she is a lesbian, and she doesn't want her woman hanging out with any guys or studs or anything like that, like masculine lesbians or whatever. And the immediate thought popped into my head, she got to heal past issues. Because honestly, I already know that I was bringing trust issues. Trust issues was snowballing from relationship to relationship. And that wasn't something that I really saw until, again, I went on this spiritual journey and I became more evolved than I was. Not, it's okay because everybody is in a different place in their journey. So, you know, where she's at, I've been. And where I'm at, somebody else has been. And where, you know, people that have reached self-mastery, one of those days we will be. But in the meantime, you know, I'm going through the motions, and wherever she is at now is where I was at maybe a year or two ago. And that was a huge thing in relationships. That was a huge thing in relationships that caused like a rift, because being super controlling and super jealous to a partner that doesn't deserve it is definitely going to make them feel unappreciated. It's going to make their loyalty feel like it's done in vain. So, you know, that's something that definitely reflects insecurity. If you don't feel comfortable with your partner hanging out with the opposite sex, it reflects probably insecurities from either the relationship you're currently in, you know, meaning that person lost your trust somehow, and now, you know, you restrict them to hanging out with only certain people. But I'm here to tell you, you can't pick your partner's friends. If they grew up with, you know, a best friend of the opposite sex, or they develop a friendship in their adult years that they vibe with, it's up to you to trust your partner, you know, to make the decision to not allow something that's going to sabotage your relationship to come in. And if you don't trust your partner to make that decision, then I'm sorry, but the guys that commented on the status today, they're absolutely right. That may not be the person that you are meant to be with. And, you know, people, they stay in relationships that they're not meant to be in all the time. I'm guilty of the same thing. But, you know, having a relationship where you feel like you have to have a leash on your partner, or you have to have so much control that you cherry picking their friends, and you know, you don't trust them, and you really don't have a valid reason not to trust them. Trust me, you're sabotaging your own relationship. So, it's a good thing to start looking into healing if that's how you feel. So, pretty much that's my opinion and the opinion of the mass majority. And to my friend that suggested this topic, you'll get there. And, oh, she did acknowledge that too. Like, oh, you know, right after the thought crossed my mind, like, oh, she got a heel pass issue. She said, I'm not having it because, you know, what I've been through in past relationships. So I'm like, at least you're aware. And so that's where the healing begins, is becoming aware that it's actually an issue and that it's not really right for you to want to restrict your partner to the point where they feel like they can't breathe a certain way without you accusing them of doing something wrong. So that's going to conclude this video. Right now, while I'm recording on my phone, I have to make them short and sweet, because any little notification that comes in chops the video right off, and I have to do multiple takes, and I don't feel right leaving it undone. So I'll keep doing take after take until I'm finally able, and I had to disable some things on my phone so that the notifications didn't come through. But I'll do more lengthy videos once I go ahead and get a camcorder, which will be probably in a couple of days or whatever. But in the meantime, in between time, till next time, peace.